眨了眼，不会看见那颗流星。如果再慢一秒，不会再结痂和你相遇。爱的出现一点都不讲理，玫瑰花一瞬间开满了大地。到底爱你好不好，我还不知道，只知道心在动摇，丘比特在微笑。哦啊，是一种直觉，是一种体味，是一种本身。哦啊，想要时刻随时启动，挡不了。当浪漫来袭，脸颊在燃烧。想每天这么想你，爱不是电影，却比电影更有戏剧性。你就在我需要的时候来临，在背景音乐里对你动了心。我在阳光下披上了你的外套，也在你怀里看见那幸福的一角。哦啊，在你的双眼，是启动我心跳。当浪漫来袭，脸颊在燃烧。当你给我第一手独家拥抱，我的心蹦蹦蹦蹦蹦跳，它蹦蹦蹦蹦蹦，为了你蹦蹦蹦蹦蹦跳，它蹦蹦蹦蹦蹦。哦，当浪漫来袭，爱出现主角。当你给我想不到的各种美好。
希望有一天能和他一起飞，当烦恼越来越 追逐烫脚吹来的风，轻轻地吹着梦想慢慢升空。红色的蜻蜓，我小时候的小小英雄，多希望有一天能和它一起飞。当烦恼越来越多，玻璃弹珠越来越少，我知道我已慢慢地长大了。红色的蜻蜓曾几何时也在我岁月慢慢不见了。我们都已经长大，
城市像一座迷宫，但我不死。谁说一个人不能走出？与你相爱，你忽然不懂，你退出。再多分岔路，回忆很清楚，我慢慢重组。怎么在爱里为家乡？ 岂能想象我们当初爱那么深，想假装你是路人，想再一次变陌生。少一点自由就蝙蝠，太多了你说我的关心是一种束缚、哦、怎么在爱里伪假幸福，太多的微笑也配不上一滴眼泪的苦，是谁犯的错，是谁犯的错，开心，因为努力生活，和你们分享荣耀的那一秒钟。如果难过，你肩膀最辽阔，你帮我带走乌云漫步的天空。如果生活少了有你陪我，我整天开着手机也感到失落。因为我们都最想看到彼此灿烂的笑容。我懂星座，却没有人。像我真的喜欢一个人安静的自由，我做的梦我坚持做到最后，就算我爬到云端也继续做梦，我唱的歌只希望能快乐，其他的我也不想要想得太多，因为我们都最想拥有自己最真的感动。听你说，听你说，我们同时拥有新的朋友，聊日出日落，因为有梦，所以更认真生活。听你说，听你说，我们真是拥有一片美好的天空，不能常联络，却更紧握我们交换的美梦，只想听你说。我懂星座，却没有人像我，真的喜欢一个人安静的自由。我做的梦，我坚持做到最后，就算我爬到云端，也继续做梦。我唱的歌，只希望能快乐，其他的我也不想要想得太多。
Okay, so hi, good morning guys, and welcome back to the lectures, Datacom lectures. So today we are already in the lecture 3, and we will be talking about network addressing. And yeah, this Friday it will be a little different from all the other Fridays because we have two classes planned for today. We will go through the concept of network addressing in the first half. So 1 hour, we will talk about all the concept first. So later on, 12:30, we have another stream that will continue from this. So you have a few hour breaks, and then hopefully you can join the stream back later at 12:30. And for the second stream, we will be going live, it will be live, and then I will show you a few examples of how to calculate network addresses, okay? So this 1 plus 2 hour, they are all continuous. We will be talking about the same thing, and it is really, really important that you follow from the start until the end, because I can tell you that this will be this will be tested in your exam, okay? So if you plan to skip any of the lectures, please don't make this to be one of the lectures. This is one of the most important lectures throughout all the other lectures, so make sure you understand the concept that we are going to share today. And for this first half hour, we'll be only talking about the concept first, because I think it is important for you to get the concept right before you start to learn on how to calculate those addresses, okay? And for the concept video, it is actually pre-recorded, and you have 4 sections of the video. I'll play the video to you, and then I'll stop at each of the sections for you to ask questions before we go on to the next one. So if you are ready, we'll start with the first video, and we'll start with the concept of network addressing. Yeah, and for those who are thinking, where is Bob? Bob will join us today in the second half of the stream. 12:30, we'll play along together with the packet tracer file, Bob the Builder, okay? And for those who think that this might be very heavy for you today, what I can tell you is that welcome to FICT lah. This is FICT.
Hey guys, in this video, we are going to look into some of the rules used in computer network. Wait a minute, I meant the rules for computer network.
I have a pen, I have an apple, apple pen.
So let's say I have a PC here, and I'm connecting this PC with a LAN cable like this. Sounds satisfying. And I connect this to another device using the Ethernet connections, like this. Sounds satisfying again. And with this, we build the simplest kind of network, which is called an ad hoc network. So this ad hoc network is also a kind of local area network. But normally you will have more than 2 devices in a local area network. So local area network is most commonly referred as to a LAN. So stay with me, it is called a LAN. So it is very important that you pronounce this correctly, but some people do call this a LAN, which is fine, whether you want to call it a LAN or a LAN, as long as you don't call this a... Okay. When people ask you, what do you learn in computer networks? I learn about... So it doesn't really sound right. Yeah, so that's it.
Local area network is also sometimes called as simply networks or subnets. So over here, we have 3 local area networks. LAN 1 in pink color, LAN 2 in blue color, and LAN 3 in yellow color. Every computer network have their own network address. For example, LAN 1 is currently having the network address of 192.168.1.0/24. The next network rule says that 2 networks that are directly connected to the same router cannot share the same network address. In our example, since LAN 1 is having the network address 192.168.1.0/24, LAN 2 and LAN 3 cannot have this network address because they are all physically connected to the same router. In this case, LAN 2 can use any network address like 192.168.2.0 except 192.168.1.0. when any host joins a new network, they'll be given an IP address in the network either by static IP or by the DHCP server.
In this example, PC1 is automatically assigned with an IP address of 192.168.1.1 by the DHCP server in LAN 1. In computer networks, end devices do not connect to each other directly. Most of the time, end devices are connected to a network switch that is then connected to a router to go on to the internet. When another new host joins LAN 1, it will be given another IP address similar to what happened to PC1. In this example, PC2 is given an IP address 192.168.1.2. Similar to how PC1 is connected to the switch, PC2 will also be connected to the switch before connecting to the internet. All the hosts in LAN 1 can freely talk to each other without needing to connect to the router. The communication can happen through the switch. In this case, we call this as a layer 2 forwarding, where switches will handle all the data being sent and received by the sender and the receiver. However, for any host in LAN 1 to talk to anyone else in LAN 2 and LAN 3, they need to connect to the router. All of these networks are connected together by connecting the switches to the router. The general computer network says that an IP address in the network has to be unique. This means that the IP address assigned to one host should not be reassigned to another host. In our example, PC1 is having the IP address 192.168.1.1. When PC2 joins the network, PC2 can get any IP address within the range of network 1 except the IP address 1.1 that is currently being used by PC1. In this case, luckily for us, PC2 get a unique IP 192.168.1.2, which is different from PC1's IP address. Well, if in some cases where you have mistakenly assigned a static IP, the same static IP to two different machines, then an IP conflict will occur. Now, what if we have an IP conflict? If PC1 and PC2 happen to have the same IP address, when the same packet goes to the router and forwarded to the switch, in this case, this becomes confusing for the network device. The network device will have a hard time figuring out who should this packet be sent to. Should it be PC1 or should it be PC2, who are both having the same IP address 1.2. Luckily for us, most modern operating systems has safety mechanism built in, and they should be able to detect when an IP conflict occur. Now, you're probably wondering, how can I find out what's the network address that I can use to be assigned to these networks? Is there a way for me to count them? Another question you might have will be, what IP address that I can assign to the host? To answer that, now we will look into the concept of subnet mask.
Okay, so guys, what we have seen earlier is the very basic concept, or we call the networking rules for a computer network. So you have seen four rules, but we can just summarize them into two main rules. And the first thing is, it is really important that you understand these rules properly, because in the future, going forward, when we are designing new networks, all the networks that we will build will follow the rules that we learn in this lecture. So you don't have to really go and memorize these rules, because as you move on, as you build more networks, this will come naturally to you. You will know what to do, what not to do. But as of now, since this is the first time you have, if you're not familiar and if this is your first time heard that you have heard of this, then it will be useful if you can try to remember them for just a bit. But don't worry, they will come to you naturally. So just to recap, every network needs to have their own network address. Like right now, we are all in our own networks. If you are streaming from your mobile phone on the highway, then you probably you are on Maxis 4G or Cellcom 4G network. If you are streaming from your home network, then you are on your own Unify network. And right now, I'm in the university network. So all of us are in our own network, and all of these networks have different network addresses. Now, this is really important because this network address allows us to find each other. For example, right now, I'm streaming on YouTube, right? So for what I'm streaming here, to get to your end so that you can watch this video, these packets that I'm sending to the YouTube server has to find a way to you. And how does the packet knows where you are right now? They are actually looking at the network address based on where you are currently located in. So network address is something like the area code. So you can think of this as if you bought something from Lazada today, for the DHL guy or for GDEX to deliver this parcel to you, they need to know your house address. And one of the informations that you can get in the house address is your postcode or your area code. And that's how they know that a parcel coming from KL can reach Gampa or can reach Penang, because they are looking at the area code to find out the destination that they should send this packet to. So network address is something similar like a postcode. And in every network, what do you have? You have all the hosts that connect to the network. So for example, in your home, you might have many devices. You might have your laptop with you, and then you might have a phone, your iPad. So all of these network, all of these end devices, they are connected to the internet, right? And for them to get connected, the very first thing, as we have learned, is they need to have an IP address. Okay, so the next rule says that if you want to talk to anybody on the network, doesn't matter whether you want to talk to someone in the own local area network or someone on the internet, you need to have an IP address. And this IP address, you cannot have the same IP address for two devices in the same local area network. So for example, if you have your mobile phone, your iPhone and your laptop that is online right now together, if you go on and check the IP address, definitely you will know that they are having two different IP addresses within the network range. This is because if you have two devices that use the same IP, then you have the problem of IP conflict. And like what you have seen earlier, we don't want this to happen, otherwise your network device will be confused on what it should do next, okay? So that pretty much sums up the basic networking rules. If you are clear about this, that's good. If you have any questions about these basic rules, you can drop your questions on the chat. Then I'll project your questions on the screen. I'll answer them before we go on to the next concept. So drop your questions here. So I guess everybody is very clear. Maybe it is too early for you, or maybe you are really good. So if you are okay, if you don't have any questions, then we'll move on to the next one. Okay, we have one question here from our friend. So Felix is asking, how does IP conflict happen? Okay. So Felix, good questions, thank you. Good morning. And how conflict happens is like what you have seen earlier in the video. It means that when you have a packet, and this packet, it by right, if everything is normal, it should only be sent to one host. Now, if you have two or more hosts that use the same IP, then the network device doesn't know who he should send this packet to. That's why you have a conflict. And how does this happen is because sometimes you might have wrongly misconfigured the static IP. So for example, if you have a PC that is using 192.168.1.1, so that is assigned by a DHCP, and then you have a new PC, you want to assign an IP to that new PC, and because you didn't know that 1.1 has already been assigned to another PC, you go and configure that same 1.1 to the new PC. That is how conflict can happen. But in most cases, when you try to do so, this conflict will be detected and you will get a notification saying that can you try to use some other IP address, okay? So we have another question from Angie, a general question. So yeah, what you have seen earlier, Angie, that is correct. We are just trying to get started with network addressing. Actually, there is a very complex mechanism behind all this addressing. What we are seeing here on this stream are just the basic example because I don't want you to get confused. And once you get hold of all the basics, then we'll move on to see some more advanced example, okay? So I guess we only have two questions. If you are fine, we'll go on to the next concept where we'll talk about, we'll talk more about IP addresses first. Because like I said earlier, without IP address, you cannot talk to anyone. So IP address is like your IC number that you need. It's kind of like an IC number, but it can be any number to identify you. So next thing, we want to learn in detail, how does an IPv4 address looks like? And then we will see how we can calculate IPv4 address.
So here you are looking at the mini map of our lecture theater in LDK3. As you can see in the map, you have two xuepa sitting in the front row. Now we'll forget about those who are sitting in the back and the middle row. So let's say, during the class, Kira somehow feels like she is Dora the Explorer and she has been talking to herself for 2 hours. So now she decided to randomly pick one of the students to answer her question. So when she is looking, she found that Alex is staring at her. So she decided to pick Alex. And this explains why most of the students are always looking down at their feet when they know the lecturer is going to pick someone to answer the question.
Hey Alex,
you are the chosen one. So when Alex are called, Alex will respond to the question. And the reason Alex responded is because he is being addressed. So you see, in this case, the lecturer addressed Alex using his name. So here you get it. People address each other by their names. Now in a computer network, the same kind of addressing mechanism is being used to address a node or a destination machine. And instead of using names, machines use the IP address as the addressing mechanism to identify the host that they are talking to.
In this example, we'll be looking at how the IP address and the MAC address and the port number works together to allow data communications to happen. So here we have two PC, PC1 and PC2, which are in the same local area network. The IP address and the MAC address of both PC1 and PC2 is as shown in the network topology. The IP address is used to uniquely identify hosts on the internet. With the IP address, we can now send a packet to any destination host that are located in some other remote networks. Meanwhile, the MAC address is a unique hardware identifier of the machine. With the MAC address, the local machines can be uniquely identified within the local area network. Lastly, the port number is a unique number for all the applications that are running in a machine. Each application or network services that are running will be assigned an arbitrary port number or a well-known port number depending on the configurations. This number is important so that the machines that receive any network packets knows that this packet belongs to a particular service. Now, let's take a closer look at an example. Say now, a packet is being received on the router.
From the packet information, we can tell that this packet is being sent to the host with an IP address of 192.168.1.1, which in our case is the PC1. This IP address is important so that the packet that is being sent from the internet knows how to get to this network where PC1 is currently located in. When the packet arrives in the local area network, this packet will be forwarded by the router to the switch. When the switch receives these packets, the switch will check its MAC address table to find which destination it should forward this packet to. The switch checks this MAC address to find out which is the rightful host. In our example, the switch knows that it should send this packet to a machine having the hardware address of ABCD AA112233, which is in our case again the PC1. When this packet finally arrives in PC1, PC1 will then check what application should it forward these packets to. This is common because on the machines, normally there are many services that are running at the same time. For example, you might have Google Chrome running in the background and playing some other games on another screen. In this case, PC1 will check the port number of the packets to decide where it should forward this packet to. In our example, the PC1 realized that this packet is destined for the applications that is running on port 1989, and based on the port number information in PC1, it knows that this packet should be forwarded to the game Wangzhe that is running on the port client port 1989. So there you have it. This is how IP address, MAC address, and port number works together to allow data communications to happen. So again, IP address is used to uniquely identify the network which a host is currently located in. Meanwhile, the MAC address is used to uniquely identify a host within a local area network. Lastly, the port number is used to uniquely identify the target applications that a particular packet is destined to. Some names are shared by many people, like Alex is actually quite a common name. Now, if there is two Alex in the class, then both of the Alex would have answered to the lecturers if the lecturer is asking Alex to answer the question. That's fine because you might have two or more Alex, but you wouldn't have the whole class as Alex. Now, if the lecturer decided to call, "Hey, handsome, yes, you, handsome, answer my question," then everybody in the class will answer the question because everybody thinks that they are handsome. But unlike people, the machines in the computer network cannot share the same identifier, or in other words, they cannot have the same IP address.
Okay, so guys, what you have just seen earlier explained that the machines on the network, they have three addresses. So like for people, we have many names as well, depending on who you're going out with. So for example, some people might call you handsome, some people call you your real name. And when you're playing games, you have your in-game names. And for the machines, they are the same. Actually, in fact, there are more than three addresses that a machine can have, but in this subject, we will focus on only three, because with these three addresses, which is the IP address, the MAC address, and the port number, a machine can already go on to the internet and talk to any other host that is on the network. Okay, so just a quick recap here. You need all these three numbers. Okay, you cannot have, you cannot say that you have only have two of these addresses without the other one, then you will not be able to use the network. Okay, and these addresses, they are used for different reasons. Now, the IP address is a layer 3 address which is used if you want to go to another network. Okay, that is the main purpose. Of course, our IP address is also used if you want to talk to somebody in your same local area network, but without the IP address, you cannot go to any other network. Okay, and specifically, I'm referring to the global, or we call this a public IP address. Now, for a MAC address is slightly different. It is a layer 2 address that come with all the network interface card. So for those who are not familiar, a network interface card, or we call this a NIC, N-I-C, is the network adapter that you can find in your computer or your phone. So for example, if you have a computer that you can go online by connecting the LAN cable, so that is Ethernet connections, and you need a net Ethernet card for you to put the cable in. So that is the network adapter. Now, if you go online using your Wi-Fi, then you have a wireless network adapter. And all these network adapters, which are also called network interface card, have one MAC address. So remember, MAC address come together with the network interface card, okay? Now, for example, what I have here, this is a network card, an external Wi-Fi adapter. So if you have a gaming PC that normally doesn't have a wireless connections, if you want to add the Wi-Fi connections, you can buy a card like this. And yeah, because this is a network interface card, like what we said earlier, it will have one MAC address. So you can remember this as MAC address is the identifier for the hardware identifier for any network adapter. And in fact, most of the number is actually printed on the device itself. So if you can see here, there's a line that says MAC address. Okay, it means that this is the IC number for this hardware. And every hardware, every network adapter that you can find on this world will have a unique MAC address. So you will not find any two network adapter that have the same MAC address. It just won't happen, okay? This number have to be unique across all the devices. Okay, so that's MAC address. And then the last one is the port number. So port number is rather simple. It is just any number, decimal number starting from 1 to 65 something something something. Okay, I don't remember the full range, but it is just numbers that is used to represent services. And the reason this is really important is because without a port number, when your device receives a packet, it doesn't know this packet should go to which application. Maybe for example, it received 3 packets. So we need this port number to tell the machines that packet number 1 goes to Facebook apps, packet number 2 goes to Instagram apps, packet number 3 goes to Wangzi apps. So that is done by using the port number. Okay, so in fact, for those who are confused about how is an IP address different from a MAC address, you can just think of this as the IP address is actually like your passport. So for you to go to other country, for you to go to Singapore or any other country, you need to have your passport. So that is the IP address. And MAC address is like your IC. So if you are just traveling within the country, locally, from Kampa to Sungai Long to Penang, then you only need to bring your IC along with you. So that is something that you can think of, like MAC address is your IC, and then your IP address is your passport. Okay, so that pretty much sum up the next concept, what you're seeing here, the three type of addresses. So just remember that we need all these three if you want to use the computer network. Okay, now I'll check the questions that you're posted, and I'll answer to your questions before we move on to the last concept video for this session. So guys, keep your questions coming. Come on, throw the questions here. So yes, we have a very good question again. Is the switch the same thing as a router? Now the very clear answer is big no. A switch is a layer 2 device, a router is a layer 3 device. And in fact, we have seen this earlier in one of the streams. So you have to find the very clear difference between a switch and a router is that a switch is used to connect your end devices to build a local area network. Okay, it's that simple. But for your device in your local area network to go to another network, for example, from Sungai Long network to Kampa network, then you need a router. So that is the clear difference here, okay? So it depends. Now, for example, if you are gamers, I'm sure everybody have this sweet childhood memory where all your friends will gather together in a place and then you'll play a lot of LAN game. So why do they call this a LAN game? It is because you only need to connect all the PC, your that you want to play on to a Switch. We don't even need the internet, and then we can play together. 10 friends, we play Diablo, we play Dota, things like that. So that's LAN. You only need a Switch. But if you want to play online games, for example, you're playing Dota 2. So every game right now is client server. The server is somewhere on the internet. Now, if you want to play an online game, you need to connect your PC or whatever you're playing on to a router. So that is the difference between a Switch and a router, okay? Okay, I'll just scan through your questions and then I'll answer whatever that I think makes sense. For those who are just spamming, I'll just leave it there so that you can just enjoy doing whatever you like. Okay, we have another good questions coming up. This is kind of a long question, so let me just format this for you. Okay. Now, if two MAC address different name, then we follow your own name, same name. Okay, let me try to make sense of this question first. I don't really get what you're trying to mean here, but if I get it right, you are thinking that if you have two MAC address, you'll follow the same name. I think you're kind of confused right now. So MAC address and IP address, they have to come together. You cannot just say I use IP address, I don't use MAC address, or the other way around, I only use MAC address and I don't use IP address. Okay, they are used for the same reason. They are both used to address a PC or a node on a network. But if you're saying that follow IP address, it means that you are confused about the concept here. So IP address is layer 3, MAC address is layer 2. So for example, now if I go for holiday in Singapore, I need to bring my passport and I also need to bring my IC. So in the airport, the police there or the officer there will check for my passport. Okay, when I check in Singapore, again immigration will check for my passport. So that is the IP address. When I get into Singapore, let's say I want to use my IC. Okay, let's say the police catch me. So show me your IC. Then I will just show my IC. Okay, something like this. So they are actually working in different layers. And to make this simple, you can just think of this as your PC will have both IP and MAC. So every time you want to talk to somebody, you will send a packet. And this packet will be sent to the destination based on your destination IP address. When this packet arrives at the switch, they will check which PC to forward to based on the destination MAC address. So if you are still confused, don't worry, in a short while, I will visualize this one using a network diagram. And that I think that with that, you will get the concept better. Okay, we have a few more questions coming up. So okay, now, again, good question. Is port number like an IC number for a network? No. IC number is actually your IP address. Okay, port number is for your application. So you can think of, maybe I can give you another example. So let's say if I am playing, when I'm playing Wangzi on this iPad right now, okay? Now, this iPad will connect to Wangzi server, maybe let's say in China, okay? Now, how does the server know that it has to send the packet to this iPad in Malaysia? They look at my IP address, the iPad IP address. Okay? Now, when the packet arrives from China to Malaysia, when it comes into my Utah network, because right now I'm in Utah, okay? I'm using Utah Wi-Fi. Now, in Utah Wi-Fi, there are many devices that are currently using Utah Wi-Fi. It is not just only my iPad. Okay, I have other lecturers here who are also connected to Utah Wi-Fi. So the packet from Wangzi server, when it arrives to Utah Wi-Fi, how can it know this packet should send to my iPad, but he should not send this packet to other lecturers' PC? Otherwise, other lecturer will think, will know I'm playing Wangzhe in the office. Okay, so this is done by checking the MAC address of the device. So again, from China to Malaysia, I know how to get from China to Malaysia by looking at the IP address. Once I'm already in Utah Wi-Fi, how do I know to send packet or the frame to this iPad but not to the other device on the same network? Is by looking at the MAC address. Okay, now once the packet get to my iPad, because I know the Wangzhe packet should send to this MAC address. Okay, how do I know this packet should send to Wangzhe apps? Because you see on my iPad, okay, if you look properly here on my iPad, I have so many apps that are running. Okay, every apps has a port number. So by using this port number, the operating system in the iPad know that this packet have to give to Wangzhe applications. Don't send this packet to Facebook because the port number says this is for Wangzhe. So that means you need these three address for a packet to get from a server back to your client device. Okay? Okay, I think we are feeling great here because we have so many good questions. That's what we should do, okay? Otherwise, you'll just be like watching a YouTube premiere with me. So keep all your questions coming. I'll answer all of them as I can. So next question, we have, what is the use for Unify router in our house? Okay, good questions. The router is there so that it helps you to forward your packets from your local area network to a destination network. So again, using back the same example, if I'm playing Wangzhe on the iPad right now, okay, so I need to connect to the Wangzhe server in China. Now, when I play the game, the packet goes from this iPad to the server. So this packet, who is the one who sent this packet to that server? The router is the one. Meaning that because I connect to the Wi-Fi, Utah Wi-Fi, so Utah Wi-Fi got one router, okay? When I play the game, this packet sent to Utah Wi-Fi router. The Utah Wi-Fi router will send this packet to Wangzhe server. That is because Wangzhe server is in another local area network. So remember, this is very important distinction. You have to get this difference very clearly. If I want to talk to someone in Utah Wi-Fi, the same local area network, in fact, I don't need a router. I only need a switch because if we are in the same LAN, we can just talk to each other using our layer 2 MAC address. But if you want to talk to anybody outside your local area network, you definitely need an IP address and you need a router to forward your packet to another local area network from your local area network. Okay? So Angie is asking us, what do we mean by layer 2 and layer 3? Yes, good questions here. If you ask this question, that means you already wake up. When we say layer 1, layer 2, layer 3, we are actually referring this to the OSI model in computer network. We have one full lecture about all this layer. So don't worry about that first. As of now, you can just think of this layer as different layer have different purpose in computer network. So on computer network, we have this OSI. If you want to know a little bit now, OSI is like a set of rules. So for example, if right now today in this stream, you see, I'm streaming these lectures using English. I'm speaking in English. But in fact, I can speak in Chinese, I can speak in some other language, right? Now, if I speak in Japanese, then only the people who understand Japanese will understand what I'm talking about, which means most of the guy. Because for some reason, all the guys know Japanese a lot. I don't know where you learn this from, but all the guys know Japanese. But what I mean here is that if I speak in Japanese, only some people know. But if I speak in English, most of you understand. I hope so. That is because we have an agreement that we speak the common language. So OSI is something like this. It is like a rules for all the devices. Okay, because you see, your devices, you have many, many different manufacturers. You have Apple, you have Microsoft, you have Google, you have Huawei, you have Cisco, you have Xiaomi. So when all these company they build their device, we need to make sure that all of these devices can talk to each other across a common language. So it cannot be like Apple iPhone can only talk to Apple iPhone, but I cannot talk to a Samsung phone. That's not right. So with OSI, that is the common language that every device have to understand, so that doesn't matter what manufacturers or what device that you are using, as long as you are connected to the network, we can understand each other. So that is OSI. And in OSI, you have all these layer 1, layer 2, layer 3. Okay. Now, again, a very good question is coming up. So, yeah, I'm glad that you think about this. When you subscribe to UniFi, the installer will give you two devices. Okay, there is one modem and there's one router. So this question here, are you using a switch or a router in UniFi network? The clear answer is you are using a router. Think about this. If the device is only a switch, then you cannot go to the internet, because without a router, you can only talk to the people in your own local area network. Remember, always need a router if you want to go to any other network. So the internet, definitely you need a router. But in your case, the device that TM give to you when you subscribe to UniFi is actually a combo device of a router and a switch. So it's 2-in-1, okay? Which is why you might think, why when we learn about computer network, we connect all the devices to the switch before we connect to a router. But when I look at my home network, there is no switch, there's only router. That's because the device is actually both a switch and a router at the same time. Okay, we have another very good question coming up. And now your friend is asking whether we can change this MAC address. Now this is a very good question. Thumbs up for you, because if you think about this, I think you are in the right place. FICT is the right place for you. Now, MAC address. The simple answer is no, we cannot change a MAC address. Like what I showed you earlier, every network adapter comes with their own MAC address encoded inside. This is actually hardwired, meaning that we actually program this number into the network adapter. You cannot change that number, which is the right thing to do, because if you can change, then you might have conflict at the MAC address layer. So we don't want that to happen. Okay, now the problem with that is if the same MAC address cannot be changed, that also means I can track everything that you do on the network. Because everything that you do, I will be able to see all the traffic, right? Now, in the network traffic, one of the things that we can find out is actually your MAC address. Meaning that I can go and find out this MAC address belongs to who. For example, this MAC address belongs to NG. Then I look at the packet, NG is playing Wangzhe. Then from here, because I see a packet going to Wangzhe server, so I say, NG, your MAC address is playing Wangzhe right now. So that's how I know NG is playing game in the lab. Something like this, which is a problem if you think that this is a private issue, then privacy issue, then this is a problem, right? Because everybody knows what you are doing just by looking at your MAC address, which is why in modern operating system, like if you are using a Windows 10, there is actually a built-in options for you to change your MAC address. Okay, don't ask me whether this is legal or this is not legal, but just know that you can change your MAC address. For what reason? For privacy reason. Now, for example, if I have an original MAC address like this, this is my MAC address. If I use this MAC address, everybody will know what I'm doing. Okay, but using the options we call this a MAC address randomizer, or we call this random MAC. This address will be temporarily changed to another MAC address. Okay, that is not this one. So if you do that, people cannot know who is this. For example, I know this is NG, but if NG used a random MAC address, it changed into a new MAC, then I do not know who that new MAC belongs to who. Okay. Now, if you want to know how can you do this, there are a few ways. If you're already using Windows 10, you can go to the setting and then you try to search for random MAC address. If you turn that options on, then your PC will automatically translate your MAC address, the real one, to a temporary random number. Okay? Now, if you do not have Windows 10 and you still want to do this, there are many software out there that can help you to change your MAC address. Okay? Okay, is the video that we played here the one uploaded on Weber? No. What you see here is new, okay? If you haven't watched another stream for the other batch, then this should be the first time you're watching this video. So we have a few more questions here. Now, if you play online game, need IP address, but if I need play a LAN game, you need MAC address. Yes, that is totally correct. You get it right. That means that if you want to host a LAN party and then you call all your friends to come over, you only need a MAC address. But like I said earlier, you still have an IP address, okay? Because every time you go onto a network, you will have IP, you have MAC, you have port number, okay? It is still there. Just that, actually, your device in a local area network, they talk to each other using the MAC address, not the IP address, okay? Now, next question here, we have PC will send information to the router, and then to the switch, and lastly, to the PC. To answer these questions, actually no. Okay, now the simple answer is a PC will always send a packet to a switch if he wants to send this packet to another guy in the same LAN. The PC will only send the packet to the router if he wants to send a packet to a guy in another LAN. Okay, so I hope you get this right. And later on in the second half of this stream, I will have one example to show you where the PC send the packet to. Okay, but to make this simple, right now just think of this, that if the destination is in the same LAN, you send it to the switch. If the destination is on another network, you send this to a router. Okay, we have a few more questions. I'll just finish up all the questions here and then we'll continue the next concept video on the stream at 12:30. So let me finish up these questions because you are really, really sending good questions. So we have 3 to 4 more to go. Now, switch connect to all the PC. Then if you use same internet as router, just give me a minute because I need time to think what you are trying to ask here. Switch connect. Okay, now if I get what you're asking correctly, the first part, you are right. The way we connect all the end devices is by connecting all of them to a switch. Okay, that's actually the only thing that we need to build a local area network. But most of the time, we need to go to another network because the services that we want to use definitely is not in your own network. For example, if you want to use Facebook or YouTube stream, you're streaming on YouTube, you need to go to YouTube server. And you are sure that YouTube server is not in your house, right? So you still need to go to the internet. And that is when you need a router. Okay, next question here. Okay, now, next question. Your friend is asking, so we use the IP address for network, MAC address for every user in the network, and port number for apps. Yes, 100%, this is 100% correct. Congratulations, I think you get the concept very right, and this is a very good way to put it. So your friend here give a very clear explanation of how is IP address different from MAC address and the port number. Okay, so yeah, your friend is right. So like I said earlier, you can think of IP address as the passport and then the, so it's like your area code and then your MAC address is like your house number. So let's say someone delivered a parcel to you. Okay, so by looking at the address, I know that this parcel should go from KL to Penang because the area code of the destination address is Penang area code. Now, when I get to Penang, I need to deliver to your house. So I will look at your house number, your street, okay? Street name, things like that. So that is actually your MAC address. And then in your house, for example, you bought an iPhone. So in your house, there might be many people living in, your mom, your dad, your brother, your dog, your cat, right? So this iPhone that you bought, should I deliver to you or to your mom or to your dog or to your cat? By looking at your name, the name printed on the label of the parcel. So that is actually the port number. Okay, so we have a few more here. If I play Wang Zhe, yes, you Chang is asking if you're playing Wang Zhe, then the packet goes from LAN to the internet to the LAN. That's correct. This is one way to put it, but actually you see, on the internet, it is also many other LAN. Okay, the whole internet is many LAN. LAN 1, LAN 2, LAN 3, until LAN 1000, 1 million. So when you're playing Wang Zhe, the Wang Zhe server is also in one of the LAN. So technically, it is from your LAN to the LAN in Wang Zhe. Go back to your LAN. Okay? Now, can we design our own Wi-Fi server like Unify? Yes, in fact, you can do so. If I get this right, you mean that you want to host your own server. If that's not right, you can ask the questions again. So I'm thinking you want to host your own server. And yeah, you can do that, but you need to learn about port forwarding. And port forwarding, you will learn this in year two. Now, another question here, which means that, okay, I'll project this question out. We use device for MAC address for a long time and use it back. Yes, this is definitely correct. So that means if you put your PC aside for 3 months and then you decided to turn it on back again, you will always get back the same MAC address, because the SA MAC address is the hard MAC address that is printed or hard-coded to your network adapter. Unless you change the network adapter, for example, you buy a new card and you install it to your PC, then yes, you can change the MAC address permanently because now you have a new NIC, okay? Now, we have a very cute question coming up. So, incognito web prevent people finding out what you are doing when tracking your MAC. Now, again, you are in the right place. FICT is the right place for you. But I'm sorry to tell you that no. You can turn on incognito in your Google Chrome or any browser, and you think that with that, nobody knows what you are doing. That is partly true. If you turn on incognito, the other people will not know, on the network will not know that what website that you are browsing. But if I do network sniffing, so there's this thing we call network sniffing, where we will get every packet that is going around the network. From there, I can still see your MAC address. So this incognito is only protecting you at the applications level. It is not protecting you when you go to the network. So after this subject, after one of the lecture where you learn how to sniff packets, then you will know that actually incognito doesn't protect you from anything. It just gives you a sense of security that you're being protected. Now the hotspot. Okay, we have a few more questions here. Okay, now hotspot also have router and switch. In fact, it is the other way around. So you see, a router and a switch is actually a physical device that connect, that help you to connect to the network. A hotspot is not real. Hotspot is logical. So for example, if I want to create a Wi-Fi network, okay, I can create a hotspot network so that you can join my hotspot. Now, that hotspot is actually just like a LAN. So we have learned LAN 1, LAN 2, LAN 3. Hotspot is just like another LAN, LAN 4 or LAN 5, okay? Except it is like wireless. So you are comparing apple and orange here. So you see, with router and switch, you can create hotspot. That is a network. So if I have a router, I can create 10 Wi-Fi network, not just one. By default, it is one. So I can create so many networks. So each of these Wi-Fi network can be seen as a hotspot. Okay, so hotspot is just another local area network. Okay, Benson have a very interesting primary school experience that we will share on the screen here. And maybe he has a control freak teacher. In the primary school lab, the teacher will control our PC by presenting screen. Is that a switch? So if I get it right, you are saying that the teacher is... Okay, I'm not quite sure what you're trying to mean here. Do you mean that the teacher is trying to control your screen, or is the teacher projecting something on your screen? But either way, it is not a switch. A switch is just a network device that connects devices together to build a local area network. Okay, for your teacher to do so, she needs to use applications. For example, she can use VNC, she can use Windows Remote Desktop, she can use even like Telnet and SSH that you have learned in Lab 1. So those are applications. Okay, what we are learning here today are the network devices. We are talking about layer 3 and layer 2. Just a little bit extra info for you. Application is in layer 5. Okay, there's one layer. Layer 5 is where you have all the Facebook, Instagram, and also the apps that your teacher used to control your screen or to show something on your screen. So I'll take one more questions here, and then for the rest, I'll just reply in the chat because I have another stream coming up. So you have one question on VPN. Okay, VPN is changing the IP address. Main point is, yeah, that is correct. So if you ever tried a VPN, what they do is they try to trick the server or whoever who are checking the packets that you are from a certain locations by changing your IP address. But the MAC and port will always be the same because the port number for applications has to be the same. Otherwise, other device will be confused. Like, what am I using? What apps is this? Okay, that's one. Now, MAC address will not change, like what I said earlier, unless you change the network card or you change the or use a random MAC program. Now, in fact, this MAC address is not sent out to the network, meaning that if you go onto the internet, nobody on the internet can see your MAC address. Only the router in your own network can know what is your MAC address. So when you use your PC to talk to someone on the internet, the people on the internet only see the MAC address of your router, but they will not see what is inside your local area network. Okay? So I guess that's it. I only have this much time for you guys. So guys, go on for a short break, and then in a short while, I'll see you again, 12:30, and we'll continue with what we left off here right now. So thank you for joining the stream. See you again real soon.